Bethesda has always claimed to have a very strict quality assurance policy with the games that they publish to you and me. However, this doesn't mean that they've always been perfect. In fact, Bethesda has put their name on some, well, some real stinkers over the years. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today, we're going to be looking at some of the worst Bethesda games of all time. For this list, we are simply going to be looking at games either developed or published by Bethesda. If their name is on it, it is eligible for this list. So be sure to let me know what your favorite and what your least favorite Bethesda game of all time is. Drop a like and here we go. Pirates of the Caribbean. Now, I didn't even know this was a game, honestly. Released in 2003 for the PC and the Xbox respectively. Pirates of the Caribbean was an action RPG based on, of course, the first Pirates movie starring Johnny Depp. Now, you may think an action RPG based on that universe could have been awesome, and it could have, but unfortunately, there was some not-so-great happenings behind the scenes during the development. For starters, the game actually started development as an entirely different game called Sea Dogs 2, which was a sequel to a pirate RPG from the year 2000. But about halfway through the development, Bethesda got the license to make a game based on the Disney movie, so they reskinned Sea Dogs 2 a bit to make it fit with the Pirates of the Caribbean theme. In fact, there was hardly anything in this game that actually had to do with the movie. The Black Pearl is mentioned a couple times, but that's about it. And overall, the game got mediocre reviews due to its slow combat, uninteresting story, and its lack of connection to the movies that made it just look like a quick cash grab. Pirates of the Caribbean: The Legend of Jack Sparrow. Following the success of the first Pirates of the Caribbean movie and the hype leading up to the second one, well, Bethesda decided to take one more stab at a movie tie-in game for the franchise. And everybody knows, movie tie-in games, they're dangerous. Pirates of the Caribbean: Legend of Jack Sparrow is a direct sequel to the first Pirates movie, and it served as a way to bridge the gap between the first and the second movies and capitalize on the fact that the second movie was about to come out. Johnny Depp actually voiced Jack Sparrow in this game to make it more authentic, and while the writing was actually decent, the rest of the game, unfortunately, was not. As opposed to the first game that was an RPG, Legend of Jack Sparrow was your standard movie tie-in action-adventure game, complete with the repetitive gameplay and very, very linear and lazy level design. The game was torn apart by critics, and Bethesda has never published another Pirates game since. Delta V. Now, going all the way back, or Delta 5, going all the way back to 1994 for this classic. Delta 5 was a sci-fi racing game, kind of like F-Zero, if you remember F-Zero for the Super Nintendo, but in first person and much more emphasis on combat. The game definitely looked cool, and it played well for the time, but it was criticized for how repetitive the level design was, as it seemed Bethesda, they had an idea for the game, but didn't really try to elaborate on it, and instead, had the player do the same thing over and over again. The game didn't perform very well financially or critically, and it ended up going out of print not too long after its release. And there's a good chance you've never seen this game, and you never will. Star Trek Conquest, for those that don't know. Bethesda used to publish a lot of Star Trek games, and a lot of them, well, they weren't good. The first lame game on our list is Conquest. It was released in 2007 for the PS2 and the Wii. Conquest was actually the last Bethesda-published Star Trek game, and it's not hard to see why. The game was set in the Next Generation era, and that's my favorite era, and it was a blend of turn-based and real-time strategy, as you participated in the Dominion War, but that was the problem. It doesn't really take a genius to figure out that strategy games don't work too well on consoles, especially not on the Wii, and the game was bashed pretty hard by critics for the gameplay, the controls, and the numerous occasions of characters from the show acting way out of character for the sake of actually moving the game forward. It wasn't a good representation for Trekkie fans. Star Trek Legacy. Next up is, well, another one. Released in late 2006 for the PC and the Xbox 360, Legacy was meant to celebrate the 40th anniversary of the franchise. It's a huge thing, but it wasn't exactly the most respectful use of the license because the game, it sucked. It was a real-time strategy game once again, and it had you going through the different eras of Star Trek and reenacting various events from them, but it was clear that the developers were more concerned with the spectacle rather than the actual gameplay. There were tons of problems with the camera and the AI, and there was this bizarre lack of key bindings for the PC, meaning you couldn't really change your controls, which that's a pretty big problem because the default controls were really, really bad. And of course, in true Bethesda fashion with this one, the game was full of bugs. Today, Star Trek Legacy is sitting with a 56 out of 100 critic score and a 4 out of 10 user score on Metacritic. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. Okay, one more at number 5. Star Trek Encounters. Released for the PS2 in 2006, this was Bethesda's first outing with this license, and it's also arguably the worst one that they did. Unlike the other Trekkie games that have to be more strategic in a story-driven gameplay, Encounters was an arcade-style shoot-'em-up game where you would pilot different ships and you would go blow things up with them with this loose story to justify all the combat. Critics weren't happy with this. I mean, they weren't. It was an obvious cash grab of a game, as it featured very repetitive gameplay, bad graphics, bad controls, and a total lack of respect for the Trek universe and canon. However, in recent years, fans have actually kind of come back around to this game as kind of a guilty pleasure game in the universe. You know, the games that are so bad, they're good. And for those of you who have played it, what did you think about Encounters? Do you think it was a cheap cash grab, or do you actually think it was okay? An Elder Scrolls legend, Battlespire. Now, the Elder Scrolls franchise is known as one of Bethesda's hard hitters, and they always have great quality. However, this wasn't always the case. In fact, back in 1997, Bethesda released a spin-off called An Elder Scrolls Legend, Battlespire, which was a dungeon crawler. According to the reports, this was originally going to be an expansion pack for Daggerfall, but Bethesda decided to make it a little bigger and release it as a standalone game that focused just on the dungeon crawling aspect of the main game. The end result was a very, very underwhelming game that kind of brought down the Elder Scrolls brand at that time, and the game was a commercial failure, and as of recording this video, it is right now the worst reviewed game in the Elder Scrolls series, and that sucks because there are some amazing games in that franchise. Brink. Raise your hand if you remember Brink. It was released in 2011, and this thing was hyped up. It was a class-based multiplayer FPS that was supposed to be Bethesda's answer to the popularity of Team Fortress 2, but just about everything was wrong with it upon release, and it didn't get a whole lot better afterwards. Its class system was unbalanced, and the gameplay, well, it was super repetitive. It also didn't help that the game was completely broken upon release. The art style was interesting on paper, but during gameplay, it was a bit of a liability because it was extremely difficult to tell the different classes apart during your combat phases, and those of you who played the class-based shooters know that being able to quickly identify the classes is a massive part of the gaming formula. So overall, Brink was a game that had a lot of potential, but it was obviously rushed out the door, and it ended up just being a huge disappointment. It was forced to adopt a free-to-play model in August of 2017, but that wasn't even enough to save the game, and it only gets an average player count right now of about 25 people on Steam. Just big shout out to those 25 dedicated people. Fallout 76. You knew it was going to be somewhere on this list, and this was released in late 2018 to critical panning and tons of disappointment from fans for countless reasons. The most obvious ones are how blatantly it was broken. The game was broken, how repetitive it was, the lack of actual content, and the insulting abundance of microtransactions despite how lacking the core game was. And throughout the following months, Bethesda only continued to dig their grave deeper and deeper as they added more microtransactions, made terrible PR statements regarding the game, and just introduced more bugs while not fixing the big launch bugs. But if you ask me, this whole game was actually doomed from the start. A Fallout game with no human NPCs and a reliance on online gameplay and PvP instead of the things that made Fallout good in the first place, that is a recipe for failure. And at number one today, Rogue Warrior. That's it. This is one game that Bethesda stamped their name on that could have been even worse than the ones we've talked about. Widely considered to be one of the worst games ever made. That is not a title you want. Released in late 2009 for the PC, the PS3, and the 360, Rogue Warrior was actually scrapped entirely and restarted halfway through development with a new team due to Bethesda reportedly being unsatisfied with the original product. Now, I would have loved to see the looks on the Bethesda's executives' faces when they ended up getting this instead. Rogue Warrior was an FPS featuring some tactical elements and cover mechanics, and you played as a Navy SEAL sent on a secret mission in North Korea in the mid-1980s. The game was ripped apart by critics and gamers, I mean, for multiple reasons. It was extremely short, it was repetitive, it had bugs, terrible shooting, bad writing, and just all-around awfulness. If you're someone who likes to laugh at bad games, well, I encourage you to go take a look at Rogue Warrior because it's one of the worst games to come out in the last decade, but otherwise, if you're not about the jokes, probably stay away from it. Don't spend any money on it, please. And there you have it. Those are some of Bethesda's worst games. Now, if you want to see Bethesda's best games, we can put that together as well. If you guys enjoyed, take a second, make sure you subscribe to the channel, turn on those post notifications so you never miss an upload, and I'll see you soon.